Next question, if you're doing road tuning, how should one go about ignition tuning without inducing knock? Okay, so it's not a case of not inducing knock. A lot of people think that if we get any level of detonation occur at all, the engine is instantly going to fall to pieces, and that's actually not the case. The amount of damage that knock will do is very dependent on the specific power output of the engine. And what I mean by this is the amount of power per cylinder, and as that power level rises, even a light level of knock can start to become quite destructive. To put this into some kind of perspective, we've probably all heard some old grandpa slogging up a hill in their 1980s Toyota Corolla in top gear, and from 100 metres away you can audibly hear the thing pinging heavily, and it sounds pretty cringeworthy. But the reality is, because the engine produces such a low amount of power, that engine's probably going to handle another 100,000 miles of grandpa using the wrong gear without any damage. On the other hand, if we tried that same performance in a highly tuned drag engine, maybe one of our import drag engines where we're looking at producing 300 horsepower per litre or thereabouts, at that sort of power level, almost any level of detonation, you're probably going to almost instantly do damage to the engine. So obviously there's a wide range between those. But if we look at what the factory GM calibrations do, this gives you some indication of what they deem as acceptable. You'll actually find that even straight off the showroom floor on a good quality pump gas, there's a huge amount of knock retard going on inside of those factory calibrations. So we can use that knock retard information to help guide us with where the ignition timing is over advanced. Now, of course, again, you just need to bear in mind that what we can get away with very dependent on the level of tune or how much more power we are producing. If I took a stock GM 6-litre LS2, where I'd be quite happy in naturally aspirated form to see a little bit of knock retard. If I then started, maybe added a couple of turbochargers and 20 PSI of boost, I'd be much less keen on seeing any knock activity because it's going to do damage pretty quickly. That question was taken from one of our free live lessons. If you like free stuff and you're the type of guy who wants to expand your knowledge, click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson. You'll learn about performance engine building and EFI tuning, and you'll also have the chance to ask your own questions, which I'll be answering live. Remember, it's 100% free, so follow the link to claim your spot.